So, for those who don't know, Moleskine have three applications. They have the Moleskine Time Page Calendar application, the Moleskine Actions applications, which is a to-do list app, and now they have Moleskine Flow, which is their attempt at challenging apps like Paper by 53 that will essentially help you to sketch whatever you need to. Now, this is currently available on iPad. It was released about 2 weeks ago, and we'll be diving into the application, giving it a bit of an overview of what it does and how you can use it. So without further ado, let's dive in. For this review, guys, I borrowed my wife's iPad, so big thanks to Becca for letting me borrow it for reviewing Moleskine Flow. So let's dive in. So here we are with Moleskine Flow, and of course, it is an application that looks very attractive. That's one thing I'd say from the start, is that the Moleskine Digital Studio team build such good apps, and I use Time Page, the sound animation, everything like that is absolutely stunning. So of course you're getting a good high quality experience. Now let's run over a few stats before we actually dive into the application. So this application is a subscription based application. For 12 months it's priced at $29.99, so fairly high on the scale. If we compare that to, for example, WeTransfer's Paper by 53, I always call it that, it's $11.99 for their subscription model. So this is a little bit higher. But again, it's important to note that this application does have a few differences. We'll try and cover on those. It's $4.99 if you want to pay monthly, and you can access all of your account information by going over here. You do get a 7-day trial, but of course you can connect up with your existing Moleskine accounts and be able to sync with that. Now it does require iOS 12 or higher, so you'd need to be installing that on your iPad, and of course it does work with the classic iPad or Apple Pencil. We actually won't be doing that, we'll be using my classic Ditos here, because I actually don't have an Apple Pencil, and this is my wife's iPad anyway. So this got a 3.3 rating on the iOS early days, that's the first 100 reviews, but of course this application has fine-tuned a few of the issues it had originally, and of course it does compete with other such apps like Paper. So let's take a look at, let's dive into this application actually, because it's quite the application indeed. So as you can see here, you have got a homepage. You've got All, which covers all of your different collections, and of course that's where you can start any new documents. Now, what I can do is I can start a new collection. So for example, let's say I wanted to start designing some book covers, let's call it book covers. Then I can go ahead and press and create a new section. And of course that clears all of the other ones, and I can create as many collections as I like. Now if I click in and create a new document, you can see here that I can get started, you know, demonstrating how all some of the features work here. But I want to start with some of the basic abilities. It's got a unique set of drawing tools. What I quite like particularly is the dark and light paper options. So what you can do is you can add a dot grid, squared grid, or plain style. So for example, if I wanted to go full white or just dotted grid, you might be able to see on the screen version anyway. It does look a lot more attractive. And that's perfect because I use the Confidant and that looks exactly the same. You've also got the grids and the lined paper in case you're doing, writing pieces. Now you do have a lot of color options. So you've got a slight yellow, you've got this like darky sort of bluish, actually it's not darky blue, it's like really like light blue. And you've also got some of the darker colors, which is more suitable, for example, if you wanted to use black with some of the white options, then you can. And you can also use some more stylistic stuff. So there are plenty of options for those who want optionality. I'm gonna go with the yellow and the dotted grid for the moment. So of course up here, I can toggle between all of the drawing settings that I have, and it does have customizable gestures. So for example, if you have the second generation Apple Pencil and running this on an iPad Pro, you can double tap and it will obviously give you plenty of customization gestures. So you can see here that you can export automatically. You can export just the screen,
the selection. So for example, if you wanted a circle or piece that you were working on, and also you can actually just do everything, including all of the pages that you have. So that's one of the many benefits of using the exports functions. So going back here, you have a few undo abilities, and let's get into some of the drawing functionalities. So let's start with using like a biro type pen. You have the ability over here to change the size, which is quite nice, like the size of what you actually have, so the nib size. So with the pen options, you can actually choose a darker version of that pen or a lighter version. And what I quite like is the animation that the actual pen color changes as you go through these. You can also give it a different nib as well. So you can change the nib and type of nib that you work with, and also the size of that nib. So you can do this all inside of, you can almost like customize your pen before you use it. Now, of course, I don't have the Apple Pencil, but I'm going to go ahead and start sketching this book cover. So I've obviously want to make a, you can tell that I did not do art. So I'm going to make the outline of this cover. And for example, if I wanted to, one thing that I'm not, there you go, I've not yet grasses being able to access this. So I wanted a bit of a darker sort of monolith color with a darker outline. So that, so I can just do the outline of the book. Well, that's way too thin. What I like about this as well is you may have noticed you can move this around. So for example, if you want to tap in, you can make sure that you get it. Now, maybe I need a different top. That's probably the perfect one. And if I go down here, I can make that book edge appear a little thicker. So you're starting to get a good idea that this is a very intricate application. And from first glance, it actually looks a lot more intricate than the pen abilities on the paper application. So if I went over here and I chose a bit of a radical different color, and I went ahead inside here, and maybe I want to choose maybe something blue as this option. You do have a different versions of blue, which I quite like. So you can go into real detail here. So let's say I wanted the internal cover to be blue, then I could do that quite easily. Now I can go ahead and change the size of that nib so that I'm making sure I'm using the maximized size. You can tell that I'll never ever be drawing some art in my life. But if I were to, you can hire me below at francesco@keepproductive.com. So what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to choose yellow so I can do the top bit a little bit like that. So in this case, I'm actually going to go with the marker pen, make sure that the size is so big. So I'm going to do the lower half of this. I have no idea. And the good thing is with this option, this pen option, I can go into it and scrubble sort of this bottom half. So you're sort of getting an idea of how this feature works. Now, the good thing is if I wanted to add the pen I was using, so for example, this color, and it obviously wanted to save it as a preset, all you have to do is press the button down here. So you can have as many pens as you'd like, which is great if you want a routine pen. Okay, so when you're coming to use the eraser, you can choose which you want to erase. So for example, what you've already done, and it's quite accurate. But if I want to undo this, I can go back easily. I should probably undo the whole thing. If you want to undo the whole thing, all you have to do is hold on the eraser and press clear document. But in this case, I don't want to do so. But if I want to do at any given point, like zoom in to the picture, I can actually do that, and I can get rid of some pieces that I've done there and really go into detail. So for example, if I wanted to sketch in particular this area, like I wanted to sort of get started with it. Obviously, it's a little bit laggy, probably a little bit faster on new modern iPads, but this is an iPad 2018 edition. I don't do art, but I can see how much detail. And the good thing is if I wanted to scrubble across this, I could do so. And the great thing is when you let go, it sort of renders in. But there's ultra wide width to these documents, which is perfect for creative. Now, just a couple of other things. If I wanted, again, to go ahead and export, then I could export everything, or I could export a selection. For example, if I just chose to select that area, I can go ahead and export in many different options. If I wanted to save it directly as an image, maybe save it to the files area on my iPad, I could do that there. So that's a really easy way to cut through. So let's take a look at the Moleskine flow section. You can go to preferences and modify some of the gestures about what finger abilities you have and what you can use your finger for, the tapping of three fingers, etc. And also there's some general ones, like for example, sound effects when you're actually writing out. And I'll play some of the sound effects now. Now, there's also obviously your account. Here's the membership options. In the UK, it's $27.99. In the monthly price, it's $4.49. And that would be billed yearly for the 12-month option. So this application is available on iPad and it does come with a subscription fee. I'll include all the rest and information below. The Actions application is $11.99 and so is a time page application per year. So this is by far the most expensive application, but it's definitely the most specific. It's something that I think users of, for example, artists and creators will be able to relate to it a lot more than I will. So if you're looking to use this for being able to sketch and design stuff, then I recommend it. And of course, it's a very gorgeous looking application. So the reason I mainly reviewed it is because of its connection to the Moleskine Suite. And I definitely think you could even use it. For example, if I went ahead out of here and created a new area, I could go ahead and use it for writing up my notes in class. So for example, if I wanted to put, you know, today, or, you know, for example, start typing away, I can do so. And the good thing about that is that if you have an Apple Pencil, it really lifts it up and make it a lot higher quality. I actually downloaded this in the App Store and got started playing with it. I believe it actually was installed in one of the App Stores and I was pretty impressed by the layout. So guys, thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you enjoyed this feature. I'll include as much information and other resources available in the description below. But thank you very much for stopping by and I hope you found this one useful. Anyway guys, thanks so much and I'll see you super soon. Cheers.